beginning of their first big recording contract. There wasn't just this Styx that just came out of thin air. Styx had been Styx for a while. But there was a time on this planet where there was no Styx. There were no Styx members. There was some future. There was a husband and wife by the name of Panozzo. On the south side of Chicago, middle class working family, they had two sons. They were fraternal twins, and they fought like hell, and they played like hell because they were musicians. And as soon as they could talk their parents into it, they got a set of drums and they got a guitar. One took the drums, one took the guitar, and they went down to the basement and got busy and just started playing. And the neighborhood started taking notice because there were windows and the sound was permeating out into the neighborhood. So there were other musicians who were just kind of budding, and they said, man, let's go see what's up in there. And they went in. Some of them passed the audition and got to play in that band in the basement, and it just kept growing and evolving, getting better and bigger. The word got out. Next thing you know, they got James Young is in the house. That man right over there. And it changed again into this big rock band. And then they got a local recording contract. That wasn't good enough. James Young took them to A&M Records and got them signed up to a big record deal. Then starts the 50 years. But there would be none of this long-winded story had it not been for the Panozzo brothers. I'm telling you that because Chuck Panozzo, your neighbor here in Florida, is in the house.